No. So as Muslims, we have to pray 5 times a day, right? Back in summer when I first moved here, it was 3:30 in the morning. So I had to wake up earlier, drive all the way to the farm, get the cows into the shed, pray pretty much here, and then just start going to work right after that.
Farmers think they have it hard. Try and be a Muslim farmer.
Yeah, because you got that responsibility, not only to your work, but to God. Assalamualaikum, my name is Muhammad Faris Kusumadinata, originally from Indonesia. I moved from Jakarta to Invercargill around 6 months ago, working on my uncle's dairy farm, and now I'm doing uni studies. I will say one last thing about Southland especially is that it's just a lot more breathable. It's nice, it's clean, it's fresh. Yeah, there's cow dung everywhere, but I think that adds a bit to the smell, doesn't it? These people here, they've been pretty accepting of like what I do. I think it's the younger people. I think it's people my age and younger, basically. I feel they are a lot more tolerating of people's beliefs and what people do, because a lot of the elderly here, they can sometimes be a bit cruel. They can maybe not be as much understanding. They're not like up in your face racism. They're just kind of like the side eye or the glance or the talking. Especially when it comes to my sister and my cousins and friends who wear the hijab. You sometimes, I've noticed, you got like, a lot of the elderly people will give them like side glances or they'll be whispering. I've had to explain Ramadan to my friends probably around 20 times already, within the first week. Because they're like, why aren't you eating? Oh, I'm fasting. Wait, is it Ramadan? Yeah. And you can't drink water? No. Wait, no water? Ready? Ready? So, not the diss on Southland, but y'all have nothing to do. If anything, I hope Invercargill establishes any sort of nightlife that isn't just drinking. I think even non-Muslims, they would like something to do that doesn't require them to get shit-faced. Right? I can't just go to a Kmart and spend my midnight there. Being in Southland also means that I pray in the most southern mosque or masjid in the world. It's unique in the sense that, hey, I am the most farthest away from Mecca. Being Muslim in Southland, I think the first thing that comes to mind is the community, because you have people from all over the globe coming to Southland, maybe to seek a better life, maybe to seek an opportunity they can't have back home. We've got people from Sri Lanka, from Pakistan, Malaysian, Indonesians like me. It's comforting is the best word I can put it. It's comforting knowing that, hey, we've all lived different lives. We've all got different experiences. We all got different dreams and hopes. But it's nice to know that the one thing that unites us is our faith and that we're all brothers and sisters at the end of the day. That aspect has been really nice here. Southland, as much as I do enjoy some aspects of it, personally, I don't see myself staying here for long. I will say if my parents see this, they're gonna kill me. So maybe. But yeah, to make friends in Southland most of the time, you kind of have to grow up with these people. I don't vibe with them the same way as I do back in Christchurch, where I'm friends with like uni students, people my age. And sure, we may have different beliefs, stuff like that, but I just find that to be a learning experience. You guys get to learn about me, I get to learn about you guys, you can teach me about New Zealand, and I can pick you up when you're drunk.